U.S. markets closed almost flat today. So the Dow Jones gave up 10 points to finish at minus 0.03%. And then the S&P, gave up 0.11%. Nasdaq gained a little bit, 20 points, to finish close at 0.14%. So overall, U.S. market closed, I would say, flat, and then oil continued its steady recovery and finished at 58.38 for 0.71%. Now, there were no major catalysts, either on the positive side or the negative side. There are still some data that were published, but those data were not strong enough in order to really surprise the expectations of the economists or the strategists in order to really move the market to one or the other direction. But this is considered, after a big run-up like we had yesterday, since 2020 was a surprise year. I mean, the end of 2020 was a surprise year. So every day where we have all new highs will be, those U.S. markets will be hitting all new highs, so basically breaking records pretty much every week from there, based on what we end up on 2020. On the crypto world, we can see that the cryptocurrencies, Bitcoin, Ethereum, Ripple, did pull back a little bit, not too much, especially after the big run-up it has following the huge news from Tesla buying $1.5 billion worth of US dollars into Bitcoin. So this was expected, you guys. So usually after a big run-up, there's always a little pullback because some people will take profit. But it's very interesting here to see that oil will continue to make a steady upward trend. Now, one of the major data that was expected on the oil and gas sector today was the actual draw from the American Petroleum Institute. So we do have a draw of 3.5 million barrels. We also had the exact number, or the actual number, for the US openings on the job market, a little bit more than the 6.5 million that was expected. So since signs of a little recovery in the job market as well. But it will be really interesting to see how the data here on the production of oil stands from last week, because even though this is the data produced by the API, the official data, which will be a market mover, especially tomorrow, it will be, the actual data coming from the Institutional Energy Agency. That's actually the official data that will act as a market driver or the market mover, especially if the data they have is in line with what the API just released, meaning we have a big surprise on the actual draw, meaning that this is still a bullish sentiment on the oil recovery, because it means that the offer is still very low compared to the demand. So this is something that we'll have to keep in mind, especially if you have some oil stocks into your portfolio tomorrow.